Hello everyone, this is lecture 7. We're going to talk about the compensation task, CPT, as one of the methods to control and inspect deep compaction in the field. So the learning objectives of this class is to describe the mechanism and procedure of compenetration test. And the second is to interpretation of CPT results for layer stratification and soil classification and relative density and the friction angle. Okay, and this compenetration test, CPT, is a static test, and it's first developed in Netherlands in 1930s, so it's a long while ago, and often called, because it's from the Netherlands, it's often called the Dutch cone test. That time it was a mechanical cone, so it's a it was quite discontinuous and similar to SPT. But in 1970s, electronic cone replaced the mechanical cone, and gave us the opportunity to get the continuous data along the depth. So the electronic cone, and we started to get the continuous data. And in 1980s, and people started to install some sensors at the cone. So they first installed the pore pressure measurement. So they applied the piezo material to get the pore pressure. And it's called the CPTU or the piezo cone. And the cone is composed of two components. One is the sleeve, which is the stem of this CPT rod, and also the actual cone at the tip. And the projected area of the cone tip is 10 square centimeter, and the diameter is about 3.5 centimeter to 3.6 centimeters. To be exact, it's about 35.7 millimeter. So if you use this diameter to get the area pi d squared over 4, then you get the cone area, which is about 10 square centimeter. And the sleeve length is, by the ASTM standard, it's about 13 centimeter. And the sleeve area is 150 centimeters, square centimeter. Here you have two load cells with a strain gauge. This load cell is to obtain the frictional force applied on the sleeve, and this load cell is to get the force applied on the cone tip. Here are more specifications. And the advantages of this cone CPT is to it allows the infield evaluation. So at the field, as you see, the cone resistance, because it's very simple to calculate the cone resistance, so you can directly make some decisions on the soil properties or soil stratigraphy. So whether you can say that it's sandy layer that you have like 10 meter thick, or clay layer like 2 meter thick, those kind of decision can be made on the spot. And it has very high accuracy and precision compared to the other drilling and testing techniques. And it's very quick, and it can test up to 300 meter deep in one day. But the disadvantages is that because you have geometric limitation, it's not possible to get the soil sample. But the SPT, on the other hand, SPT, you can use the split spoon sampler, soil sampler, so that you can get the soil sample directly. So there's a pros and cons, but the people install some sampler to get the fluid in the CPT, so that for the environmental engineering purposes or the practices, people get some fluid sampling or the gas sampling using the CPT. The equipment has standard cone dimension tip, like I said, 10 square centimeter of the tip area, and the apex angle is 60 degree, and sleeve has the area of 150 square centimeter, and low capacity of the cone is 5, 10, 15 ton. So then, what can we measure? So during the penetration, actually we control the penetration rate to be about 20 millimeter per second. So it's about 2 centimeter per second. And during the penetration, you can get the cone penetration resistance. That's measured on the tip. So you measure the force on the cone and divide by the area, then you get the cone resistance. So cone or it's often referred to as tip resistance. The unit is kilogram force per area, so kilogram F per square centimeter. And in the side friction along the sleeve, you can get the side friction. And also you can measure the force acting on the sleeve by the friction, and if you divide by the sleeve area, then you get side friction, which is also the force divided by the area, so kilogram per square centimeter. And there's a parameter called a friction ratio. So it is the ratio between this friction, side friction over the tip resistance, and also open expressed as a percent by multiply 100. And RF as a symbol, RF or FR is used. And at the cone, you can also install the pore pressure measurement by installing some piezo material. So you can measure the pore pressure or pore pressure dissipation rate, and inclinometer. Using the inclinometer, you can also measure the inclination. So it can give you some information whether this cone is deviated like this, so that you can correct it for the depth calculation. And temperature, also electrical resistance, or the shear wave velocity. So there are many attempts to install some sensors at the cone to get some more rich information. So let's move on to the handout. This handout briefly explains the cone penetration test. CPT, so it shows about tells about the history and the advantages and the equipment description, like apex angle, or base area, the friction sleeve area, so on. So please read details. And so here, the cone penetration test, or the cone penetration resistance, so this is the tip resistance, and the frictional resistance of the friction jacket can be measured separately, but at the same time. And the cone section is pushed at the constant rate of the 20 millimeter per second. And the advantage is it has high accuracy and continuous data recording and possibility of including additional sensors. So people use inclinometer to measure the deviation from the vertical, thereby preventing errors in detecting soil layers. And it is popularly used in the offshore investigation and also in the environmental remediation, site investigation, chemical and groundwater sampler can be used in conjunction with CPT, right? Chemical and groundwater sampler, to get the liquid and the gas sample. So it shows the simple schematics of the CPT. here the friction slip, and here's a friction slip and cone tip, and you have a piezo element to get the pore pressure. And what you get is the cone resistance and the local side friction FC. The cone resistance QC can be computed by dividing the QC, the large QC, the force, by its base area. So and also the side friction is the same, the force divided by the area, and RF is the friction ratio. And here the high QC means that it's sand. So as the particle becomes larger, because it's difficult to penetrate, you have a high cone tip resistance, and high side friction can be obtained when you have fine soil. So this means that in terms of the friction ratio, as you have finer grains, high RF, and coarser grains, you get the low RF. So using this kind of side friction ratio, the friction ratio, and these two values, you can identify the soil layers. So it can be also correlated to the soil classification. And the undrain strength SU is correlated to the QC value here, and it's corrected for the vertical effective stress. And there's a cone factor and K. For example, so this graph shows that the typical typical result that you get from the field. So here you have a tip resistance QC, and it's a side friction FS, and this is the friction ratio RF, and see that QC is pretty consistent for the first layer, and then suddenly you have a jump at the friction ratio and the side friction, right? So probably you have a homogeneous layer up to this point from the ground surface, maybe layer one or the section one, and according to the QC here you have another layer. And so you can see that it's pretty consistent, and then here you have another layer, so section 2 and section 3. But interesting thing is that this might be some kind of a transition. And you have a spike here, and right, another here. Probably there could be some anomaly. Yeah. So this spike may indicate some anomaly in the layers with the high resistance. So figure 12 shows the soil classification chart based on the CPT result. That's by Robertson and Campanella. And this is pretty useful chart. You can see the friction ratio as you go through the right side, it's more like finer soil. Okay. Here is a coarser soil. And for the QC, the cone resistance, it means that it's soft. And this means that as the cone resistance increases, it's a strong or it's a stiff soil, okay? Or the coarse soil. So here is a gravel and sand and silty sand, As you go through here, it's more finer soil, the clay. So again, the sand has the high QC, but it has low FS. And the clay has a high FS, the frictional resistance, but it has low cone resistance, contact resistance. So this can give you some guideline to interpret the CPT. Here shows the relationship between the relative density and the cone resistance. So QC over the relative density dr with the vertical effective stress. So this can be a good chart. And the last one is to show you the relationship between the cone resistance QC versus the friction angle of the sand. So here the QC, and you have a different friction angle. So from 30 degree to 48 degree. With respect to the depth and the vertical effective stress.